Hey guys, Mike here. So this video is going to be about what is the best type of paint you should use for your garage floor. Now we do a lot of garage floor coatings. We specialize in that. I do a lot of them for my business. Here's a before and after of the type of coatings we do on a garage floor. This is a big garage floor here. Got the concrete all prepped. And here's what we do after we put the paint on it and broadcast flake into it. So that's what this video is going to be all about. If that's what you're looking for, the best type of paint to put on your garage floor, I'm going to tell you what it is here. So make sure you hang out, and I'm going to show you at the end of the video a couple different types of concrete paints you can use and get online to use for your own garage floor. But the first thing we got to do is we got to prep the floor, and that's what I'm talking about right here. So if your garage floor already has some type of coating on it, some type of sealer, some type of concrete paint that you previously put on, we got to grind that stuff off. So if it doesn't, if it's just a concrete floor like the one I'm doing here, then all we got to do is scratch up the surface, create a good profile for the concrete paint to bond to, stick to, and adhere to, so it doesn't peel off under hot tires. And if we're going to do that, then there's a few ways we can do that to make it, you know, as easy as possible for you. Now, here's one that we were doing that already had an epoxy coating on it that was in really bad shape. So we're using these 7-inch hand grinders hooked to vacuums, you know, and they have a diamond cup wheel on them. And we're just grinding off that previous coating. So if that's your case, this might be the best way for you to get that other coating off and get you down to good concrete. Now, this is another tool you can use, and you can rent these at most Home Depots that have rental stores. You can rent this prep tool here, and it goes on the bottom of just a regular floor buffer, and you can see it's got some diamond sanding pads on it. And that works really good too to prep the concrete, get it clean, create a good profile for the concrete coating to bond to. You can see how it cleans the concrete there, gets it all good and scratched up. And that's what we're doing here on this floor, is we're using that prep tool just to prep the surface of the concrete for a coating. So we do this all the time with our concrete coatings. It's a really good way to prep concrete. And like I said, you can rent these at most rental places. But for this one, I'm just using a simple 5-inch hand grinder. It's a Bosch hand grinder. You can get it right on Amazon. You can get the shroud for it, the vacuum attachment, and then you can just hook it up to a regular shop vac, and you can use a dust buddy too if you want. I'll have all those links and down in the description for you guys to check them out. But once you get the floor all ground and get it the profile that you need, the next thing is just vacuum it to clean it, and then you're ready to go. So what I'm using is a two-part polyaspartic concrete floor coating here, and you can get these in different colors. I'm using a tan today, so I'm going to coat this, and it's going to have a tan base coat. And then what I'm going to do is that blue bucket you see on the left, the Lowe's bucket, that's got some flake in it, some chips or flakes or whatever you guys want to call them. What do you guys call them down in the comments? I call it flake, but I'm going to broadcast those flakes into the base coat here you see me rolling on. So, and I'm going to have a full broadcast, so I'm going to completely cover the whole floor in that flake. But this is the best type of paint to use right here, this polyaspartic, because in my opinion, you know, this is what we use for all my customers. In my opinion, this stuff just, it really adheres the best to the concrete. It better than epoxy, better than your acrylic paints you're going to get at your big box stores for sure. This stuff doesn't yellow in the sun like epoxy does. It is more scratch resistant, more abrasion resistant than epoxy is. So it's going to hold up a lot better to whatever you're going to do in your garage, especially if you're driving over it with your cars every day. So the polyaspartic coatings are much better, in my opinion, than any other type of concrete paint you're going to buy. So that's what I recommend. And again, hang out to the end of the video. I'll show you a couple different companies you can check out to get your polyaspartics. So what I'm doing is, you know, I mix it up. It's most of these polyaspartics are a 1-to-1 mixing ratio, a part A, part B, 1-to-1. You mix up whatever your coverage is, you know, they all have a little bit different coverages. This one I'm using goes on at about 200 square feet a gallon. So, you know, if you're by yourself like me, you don't want to mix up too much at a time. I'd mix up, you know, maybe a gallon, do about 200 square feet at a shot, or even a half a gallon, do about 100 square feet a shot if you're all by yourself. It, you know, all these polyaspartics, like epoxies, they have a dwell time, or they have an amount of time that they're going to last in the bucket before they start to heat up and go bad. So the best thing to do is get it ribboned out. You can see how I pour out a ribbon on the floor, and then I get that rolled out pretty quick. And then I roll out another ribbon. I mean, most of them are going to give you 20 minutes or so to work with. So if you only mix up a small batch, you're going to have plenty of working time to get this down. You can see I'm doing this whole garage. This was just a single bay garage. It was about 16 by 24. So I'm getting the whole base coat down on this one today. If you're doing a lot larger garage, you know, you can do a section of it, and then you can broadcast the flake in it, and then you can do another section, broadcast the flake into it. But for a smaller garage like this, you should be able to get the whole base coat rolled out like I am before you go back and start broadcasting your flake. So I got it all rolled out. As you can see, I'm wearing these spike shoes, kind of like baseball cleats or softball cleats. You can actually wear the baseball cleats if you want, or you can they have special epoxy spike shoes you can wear. I'll have them down in the description below too. You can check them out. But you're going to want to walk right back in it, and that's how you broadcast the flake into the floor. You just throw it up in the air, let it settle down in the floor. You want to completely cover the base coat like I am if you're going to do a full broadcast. This is what we always do, full broadcast. I never do any partial broadcast. It's kind of difficult to get the, if you only do a partial, you know, it's difficult to get the flakes even in the floor. Sometimes you'll get them thicker in spots than others. Doing a full broadcast is pretty easy. And it, what the flake does too, is it helps add some durability to the coating, and it really hides, you know, any little scratches or even dirt on the floor. It helps hide that. So now what I'm doing, you know, this is about a couple hours later. The coatings dry pretty quick. A couple hours later, or this could even be a day later, we scrape the flakes with just a floor scraper. So that's a metal floor scraper. And I'm just lightly scraping the tops of the flakes, removing any of loose flakes, removing and smoothing out any flake that's kind of sticking up out of the coating. We want to smoothen that flake out really, really good before we put the top coat on. So I scraped it in two different directions. I went one direction, I went east to west, then I went north to south when I was scraping it. And then after you scrape it, you got to vacuum up all that excess flake, all that loose flake now you've just created. You got to vacuum it all up and get it cleaned out. So in case you guys don't know me, my name's Mike Day. I specialize in all types of concrete work. We do all types of concrete flat work, and we do a bunch of these types of concrete coatings. So if you like that kind of stuff, you know, please go down there and hit subscribe. Also, hit the bell notification with the all, and I come out with a couple videos a week. That way you'll be notified whenever I come out with new videos. So I'm mixing up my top coat. Again, this is a polyaspartic. Also, it's a clear polyaspartic. It's a 1-to-1 mixing ratio. This one I'm using goes on at about 100 to 120 square feet a gallon. Again, if you're using whatever manufacturer you're using, make sure you check their specs so you're putting it on at the right coverage rate. And the way you can, you know, if you mix up a gallon and you know you got to go about 120 square feet, then you just measure that out before you stop rolling it on and mark that out on the wall somewhere where your 120 square feet is. That way, you know, you make sure you're getting the right coverages. So you can see I'm ribbing it out again. I'm going back over it, rolling it out real good. And then what I do is I do a final back roll for my last pass. You can see I went from one side all the way to the other, east to west, for my final back roll. So I mixed out, you know, a small kit there, and I finished up that kit, and then I'm mixing up my second batch, and I'm going to get this all rolled out. And again, my finish pass is always from east to west, west to east, one final pass. So I don't leave any roller marks or roller lines in the top coat. We don't want to do that. So how many of you guys want to do your own concrete floor paint on your garage floor? Let me know down in the comments if you're thinking about doing that. Again, with the kits, I'm going to show you a couple different manufacturers and their kits here coming up real soon. With these kits, they're pretty easy to use. I've used them both, and I like both of them really good. That's why I'm recommending both of them to you. You know, if you follow my instructions, if you join my Concrete Underground, I have a link for that down in the description too. You know, there's some trainings in there on how to do epoxy floors, so that'll help you out learning how to do this also. But so here's one of the kits, Epoxy to You Polyaspartic. So I'll have a link for them down in the description. I'm not affiliated with either one of these companies at all in any way, but I do use their product and I really like it, so that's why I'm recommending it. Flexmar is another really good polyaspartic garage floor coating, and both those products are really easy to use, easy to mix up, easy to roll on, and they're very durable. So that's what I recommend for a concrete floor paint. We call it a polyaspartic coating. Thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you on the next video.